at Guilford College on a beautiful Wednesday with Coach Chris Rusevich. Coach Rusevich, off to a good start, 2-0 beginning for this year. And again, you got to feel good about the first two games where your team's been playing.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt. I think our situation last year is we started out 2-0 as well. As I keep trying to tell people, after you get those victories, you enjoy it for about 24 hours. But we're 8 games from not having a good year. So, you know, being 2-0 is a good start. It's given a lot of confidence. We're excited about the next two opponents coming up, which are both Division I schools, and kind of see where our kids can play with.
What about that trip coming up to Davidson? We want to go back and talk about the previous games as well. But Davidson, you see them on the schedule. That's a team Guilford hasn't played in a long time. Several years since you guys played them. Many years ago, I think they played Davidson back in the day, but it's been a long time since the Wildcats and Quakers got together.
Yeah, I think the most exciting group will – there's a couple exciting groups. Us as coaches, when we had the opportunity to play them, it was pretty exciting for us to be able to go and compete at a different level, a higher level. Players obviously got excited about that. As always, those hopes and dreams to play at a high level, being able to go down and play in a Division I facility and play against a Division I opponent is something we're excited about. But the alumni base is pretty excited, too. I think bringing back that state rivalry with a two-year deal and to be able to play them back-to-back years, I think there's some excitement there, too. So all in all, I think this is going to be an exciting week for a lot of reasons.
And you think about it, too, they're coming off a tough loss against Western Carolina, so people might look at that and say, well, that's a Davidson team, Guilford's playing, but boy, Western Carolina, they really stepped up their level and played, taking on the Catamounts, too.
Yeah, you know, you go back 2 weeks ago, they beat a Brevard College 30-7, which was a Division III institution. They go into the next week and play against a full scholarship Western Carolina, and they did some good things against them. You know, obviously, I think they had some mismatches with some size and speed, but I think it's just a matter of we're not sure what team we're going to get this week, but like I said, we're just trying to prepare and make sure we don't lose the game, that they have to actually beat us if they want that chance.
And let's go back to your team, the way they played so far this year. A tough year to finish. You got, like you said, good start last season, good start this year. Carson Miller, what's the difference in Carson Miller this year from last year? Probably about the same size he was before, but something's changed in the way this kid's playing this year, off to a very good beginning for him, too.
Well, he actually lost weight. He's down about 15 pounds, which
that's
I think
good.
Helped his conditioning. I think that also helped him in terms of, you know, on those long drives, being able to stay mentally focused on what we're doing. The other thing was, is when he came in last year, he had a year off. You know, I think there was a lot of rust we were trying to get through, and as the year went on, he got better. But I think there's a lot of reasons behind it, where this year I think he really took those 9 months, put himself in shape, put himself in a position to understand our offense throughout the spring. He's obviously having an exceptional year, and we're excited about, you know, where he's about to go.
He's probably pumped up about playing Davidson, too, since he's a North Davidson guy back in high school. That's not too far away from his home, going toward Lexington, going toward Davidson. He's got to be excited, too, about being able to play a team at that level. Plus, you've got Derek Bell back this year, too, off last year's team. Injured last year. He's a multifaceted guy. This Derek Bell can do a lot of things.
Yeah, we always knew that. I mean, coming out of his sophomore year when he had 2,400 all-purpose yards. I mean, he had 2 punt returns for touchdowns, 2 kick returns for touchdowns, multiple touchdowns as a rusher and runner that year, was a backup running back. So, again, still getting all those yards. Whereas the second year with that injury, I mean, he was averaging close to about another 250 yards a game. So no one's surprised, or I guess the more important thing is the fact that he's overcome this injury and through the rehab is back to full strength this early on. And it's only going to get better. I mean, you can see he's even a little rusty right now. And we just think each week as he gets more and more opportunity, it's going to, the vision and the speed and everything's going to start coming back for him as well.
And he had a very good game against Methodist. I think he may have broke some records as far as all-purpose yardage goes.
Yeah, he broke the school record, the ODAC record. He also broke the NCAA record for most punt returns in a game with 11. Obviously, you got to give credit to defense to allow him to have to punt it that many times, which was 17. So, yeah, I mean, there's no doubt, like I said, and really he only played about 3/4 of that football game. So, you know, I think there's a lot of room to grow. We're able to get him the ball in his hands in many different ways. Obviously, with Hunter Causey in the backfield as well, you know, being a 1,000-yard back for us allows him to not necessarily have to be the main ball carrier all the time. We can get it with him punt return, kick return, as well as receiving the football.
If there was a silver lining to Bell's injury last year, it did allow you to develop and give Hunter Causey a chance to get ready, and he's ready to help out this year again just as much as he was last year.
There's no doubt. I mean, he's leading our team in rushing right now. He's doing well. You know, we have Eric Brandon-Dean as well as our third pack, which we think is not much of a drop-off by those two at all. And actually, we have a true freshman out of Mount Tabor High School, Daquan Mason, who had a touchdown and I think 30-some yards rushing in this game as well, that we think is actually, you know, could help carry the load as well. So we think we have a four-headed monster back there that can really do some damage.
What about the receiving corps? Tariq Russell and others have began to step the game up early. I know you got some good receivers and some good targets there for your quarterback to be able to find those guys, Mr. Miller.
Yeah, you know, I think with Russell being rookie of the year last year, what he was able to do, develop, put on about 10 pounds, improve his speed, improve his understanding of the game from a freshman to sophomore year, and that's definitely showing. You know, he's faster, he's been able to, in some of the games last year. He'd get open in the open field and wasn't able to outrun people, where this year he's able to do that, which is why he's putting up all those yards. You got Carson's brother, Khalil Mill, who transferred in here as well, who's a big threat on the outside, who, again, is just a freshman, just trying to get it figured out and understand what we're doing here and get the system. Britt Smith, another transfer out of UNC Charlotte we recruited a couple years ago out of Western Alamance, is here doing well in the slot. You got Hezekiah McKinnon back. I mean, we are so deep, you know, with Rontavious Miller and Desmond Marshall and Monte Johnson. I mean, we've said it. We have so much depth in our receiving core. We're about three deep at every position, and basically we're playing with anywhere from 10 to 12 receivers every game, which helps with conditioning. You know, it gives our guys an opportunity to, you know, basically out-condition our defense and be able to, you know, stretch the field and do some things. So there's no doubt he's got plenty of targets out there.
Good thing, too. You give the defense a lot of different looks. You go with a three package here, three package here. You just keep the defense off guard. They don't know who's going to be covering when the guys come out there.
That's it. They don't know who the heck we're going to have to try to double and high and low and different things. If they want to go after one guy, we have other guys that can get open, too. So there's no doubt we have a lot of threats out there.
It's good to have the Miller brothers good, too, because I'm sure their receiving practice goes all the way back to the backyard, back when they were kids.
There's no doubt. In camp, we had to try to slow them down a little bit because they kept wanting to go after each other. But you still have to be able to read a defense and still have to figure out what's going on out there. And, you know, our objective is to get all the guys open as much as we can and get the ball to the right people.
Talking a lot about the offense, plenty of offense to go around. What about the defense so far this year? Because they've had some very good openings to the year this, too.
Yeah, you know, we played against Huntington College in week one. They were number three offense in the country a year ago, you know, averaging 48 points a game. We held them to 24. I know it's a new year, but they were averaging close to 600 yards a game, and we held them to under 500, or right around 500, I think it was. So, you know, and there was a lot of mental breakdowns there. I mean, every college football program goes through it the first game. There's a lot of things you got to learn, a lot of the butterflies, the anxiousness of our kids out there. Defense actually played very well in that game, and we were excited about that. But I think they've improved that much more in methods. As I said, we forced them to punt 17 times. I mean, when your defense can do that and get the ball in the offense's hands that many times, that's just getting extra possessions. I mean, they were three of 22 on third down conversions. So our defense is actually being kind of, I should say, overlooked by the offensive numbers right now. And again, that usually is traditional, happens when your offense does so well. But our defense is playing at a high level, and I think it helped with them competing against that explosive offense all through camp to prepare themselves for the season.
And that Huntington game, it was kind of you didn't go off to a very fast start, but again, they kind of hung with you early, and you guys finally able to find a way to run past Huntington and put them away.
Yeah, I think the key there was, one, we had a goal line stand, which right after the goal line stand, they went for four downs in a row on the 1 yard line. Defense again did extremely well, hit them out of the end zone. But then we followed up with a 97 yard touchdown pass, you know, which then put us two touchdowns ahead. And then, you know, obviously later on in the game, there's only one turnover, and it was our defensive line. I think Jared Russ came off the edge, strip sacked the quarterback, and again, that able to put us another touchdown on the board. So I would say those are two major contributions to the turnaround and being able to pull ahead in that football game.
Well, so much your local guys, Carson Miller locally from North Davidson, and you got, I think, Steve Gordon, slip right out of Western Gopher, big lineman, about a senior. He's put in four good years for you. And you got that colossal kicker, Kaiser, back again this year. Couldn't find him on the opening day roster, but found him later in the box score of the game. And Harrison Kaiser is a very strong weapon. That guy could have been a D1 player for any school, and here he is with the Gopher College Quakers. Not having a punt this year, you've helped him out some there, take some punting dudes away. Boy, he can really kick off. He can kick extra points. Kaiser's a big weapon, and good to see those local guys helping you out.
There's no doubt. He's had 8 points in the first game and missed a field goal this past weekend, or else would have had the same amount of points again. But he is a weapon, and, you know, able to kick him out of the end zone, that alleviates another entire offensive play as a kickoff return. Chase Mitchell's back, and he was our punter last year out of North Davidson High School as well. He's back, and, you know, he got hurt in the Methodist game a year ago with his ACL. So having those two compete all through the camp, and to be honest with you, one just has a little bit more of a hang time, and that's really the only difference between the two of them, but they're both very strong punters. So, like I said, it is nice to have the local product who could have went some other places, you know, stay home and help us win some football games.
And we talked about the opening opponents, Huntington and also Methodist, almost like a USA South Conference to begin the year.
That's right.
But one USA South Conference member missing this year. No Super Bowl this year. Going to kind of miss the Super Bowl. It had to be stopped, but I guess the reasons behind it. I guess Davidson may be replacing that on the schedule possibly, but missing the Super Bowl, hope to get that going again someday.
Yeah, we're hoping so. We're in conversation right now. You know, I think the key for them was the Greensboro one to kind of get things in motion, get their program rebuilt, get things going over there, which was, you know, completely fine with us. We picked up Huntington in place of them at the time. Davidson actually picked up because USA South expanded their conference with Brevard, so we had to find a game in there, and that's where we ended up picking up Davidson. And then, of course, with Catholic University dropping out, that's when we picked up Jacksonville University down in Florida. So we got two really good ones coming up. We're excited about it, and we'll see where things go.
And a lot of games to open up the season on the road. Big road schedule early.
Yes, we played four of our first four games are on the road. And then, of course, the good news is our, when we take our conference play, we play four conference games out of six at home. So we're excited about that.
And you got a new man leading the direction here now, too. Got Nelson Bob coming in, a former football man himself back in the day. Good to have the new AD on staff. I'm sure he told us he's going to that Davidson game. So you'll probably see him there pulling for the team definitely on Saturday.
Yeah, we're excited about the transition. You know, some people think change is never a good thing. It's just something you just got to accept. It's like a adverse situation. You take it on. You find the positives in it, whatever it may be. But he is a supporter of football. Obviously, being a former football coach, I think maybe he's just excited to be a part of a program that has football again, where UNCG hasn't had that. But he seems pretty excited about the direction we're going.
What's the key to make sure you guys are 3-0 after the game at Davidson?
Well, the key is to control the ball. You know, I think Davidson's very well coached. I think they're smart. I think they're going to be very big up front on both sides of the ball. They play very sound. We got to go in there and match all that and try to take advantage of hopefully taking the ball away, not turning it over, and try to score more points than they do. And I think if that happens, we're in good shape.
Good year for football in the city. You got the NCAA off to a 2-0 start. Greensboro picked up a win on the road to Gallaudet. They're 1-1. Gophers 2-0. Good year for football in the city. And good to have you back on board again, Coach Rusevich.
Great. Appreciate your time. Thank you.